You're accepted.
Thank you guys. Looking forward to this matchup. I think this is going to be just as close, if not even a closer one here, as it will be RNG on the defense first up here. Excuse me, on the offense first up. Galeforce on the defense here. Pick wise, we're going to see Jesus actually on the Reaper. A Reaper, Genji, Pharah trio coming through here from Renegades right away. What are your initial thoughts on this here?
I think the only thing that's actually surprising is actually Jesus on the Reaper, and the Reaper has been coming up a little bit more often recently, but I think in this context it's actually a little bit surprising. But the triple DPS, not surprising at all, especially along with Sherlocky on the Zenyatta as well. They're just going to try to find the early damage, and he's going to be able to support Megachu as well, who does find that opening pick there onto Ultimate Web.
Well, going into this matchup today, you know, both these teams had had a difficult road to actually get to where they are, and we actually see Renegades finding a few kills, going to make the rest of Galeforce actually back off of this. We see Mooma and Calvin going behind the first checkpoint here, and look how aggressive Megachu is actually getting off of this one. Might actually be taken down. Calvin comes through with the kill, as they potentially are going to look for a regroup here. We'll have to see if they're able to make it back in time. He's now actually going to be able to get onto the point in time, or rather, that's Ultimo F on the point. Going to try for something. Gets taken down, though, by Sampa, who's actually taken down in the end. So it's a pretty good trade here for the offense, as they are going to be able to come through. Jesus finishes off both tanks on the Reaper, and they should be able to come up with this first checkpoint here.
I think one of the biggest worries about this this roster here for Renegades was that when they brought in Saipe, where was Mangachu going to go? And that was a big concern, because Mangachu is a really, really solid DPS player. I mean, dating really far back until basically the first time I remember seeing him, I think it was like 6 months ago, where he was playing a lot of this Pharah here, and they were worried, you know, is he going to be able to perform on things like the Zarya? I mean, they just got rid of the Zarya player, and they just put him on the Zarya with him. They're playing triple DPS. Jesus coming up with a huge triple kill for his team there, and they are just running this one.
Look how aggressive they're getting. This is looking like what we saw from Selfless on Hollywood right out of the gates, except they were on defense here, and this is Renegades getting so aggressive off of their initial point A push there. But something to kind of keep in mind is where these teams are coming from. I mean, you're looking at a Renegades team who looks really strong, but has struggled in the winter premiere. I mean, they're on, I believe, an 8-series loss streak, and 7 out of 8 of those were 1-2 losses. So super close ones, and looking to change something up, of course, as well with Saipe, who's actually gonna be dropped right away by the Tac Visor coming out there from Calvin. Boink actually coming through with another kill. They're gonna be able to turn this one around. Basically the first sign of life we're actually seeing from Galeforce here in the semifinal matchup.
And Calvin finally getting a short breath of life there, as he's been kind of struggling to try to deal with Mangachu and Saipe for the duration of this match here, but finally with that ultimate there coming out with a tactical visor, really kind of finding some validity at the moment. But Mangachu still really not seeing as much pressure from Calvin that I think I would have liked to have seen. When you expect a lot of great things from Calvin, I mean, he has some of the nuttiest aim in the NA region here.
And he actually just picks up that kill on the Mangachu, who was mid barrage there, got him with the Helix, as we do actually see an attempt. Oh, Juvenile actually brought the hammer down. Unfortunately, not going to be able to find anything off of that. Good turnaround coming out there on the side of Galeforce, who really need to buy themselves a lot of time here. There was really no point A hold initially, and coming out of the second checkpoint, how aggressive Renegades got off of that and pushed the payload so far. It's good to see a bit of battle back coming out here from Galeforce.
Quick swap though coming out from Saipe. He's going to go over to the Winston here, trying to deal with Ultimo Web and maybe put some pressure down onto the back line there, especially Bonnie being a big one. But Jesus actually getting down incredibly low. The Helix Rocket comes out here from Calvin. He's going to be dropping surely around the corner. Nonetheless, they do manage to kind of fend these guys off a bit. Jesus is going to fall there, and that's going to force the rest of Renegades back. And it seems as though Galeforce has done quite a good job actually turning this one back around, as you were saying.
Galeforce coming off of 4 actually pretty big wins yesterday. They 2-0'd VV Adventure, an EU team who is pretty solid. Beat out Tempo Storm 2-0, and then Dignitas 2-1, and then finished it out with a 2-1 over CLG. So a pretty exciting day for them. Nonetheless, there's Calvin up top with the Tac Visor. Gonna get reeled in by Mangachu. Doesn't quite finish him off. Had about 50 HP. Eventually, he will be taken down here. And it looks like they might be able to move forward. But after this one, Ultimo Web gonna get hooked in. But they moved the payload back so much, I'm not sure that they might be able to get this one. Galeforce might have an opportunity to actually get a full regroup here if they do happen to lose the remaining members.
They already did win a battle where they had to come out of this spawn here, and Cyber getting really aggressive now as he is coming out of that ult with that full heal. Do you see the final respawn coming? And that's Boink coming through. Not exactly the fastest player here coming out on Roadhog, but nonetheless, we are going to be seeing them with a chance to contest here and engage, and that's going to be without Mooma and Boink here, so a 4v6 without a frontline core.
The Dragonblade from Ultima Weft was the real question mark there. He only got Jair in the process before being taken down, as he was actually kind of skipping around the one of the terrain marks there. Unfortunately, wasn't able to get a whole lot off of that, and Scythe comes through with two kills to finish that one off. They still have that nano boost from Sherlocky as well, so 225 remaining, still plenty of time here to come through this final bend for Renegades.
And look at the swaps actually coming out for Galeforce. We see Ultima Web going over to the Reaper, Calvin going over to the Zarya. That's going to actually do wonders to try to deal with the Winston, but the Winston did just swap, and now Saibe's actually gone over to the Zarya, and Mangachu's on a Bastion.
That's an interesting pick. We'll have to see if it pays off for him. Jesus looking to get something with the pulse bomb. We actually see Juvenile bringing down the hammer. Is there enough follow-up? They come through with three kills. Nano boost onto Calvin, who is, of course, now on that Zarya pick. He's really not going to get anything done with that nano boost, unfortunately, as they actually try to hook in the Bastion, but wasn't taken down in the end. That's going to give a situational advantage, or excuse me, a positional advantage to Mangachu on that Bastion pick here, and it looks like they should be able to move forward just a little bit more, maybe one more team fight from Galeforce. Let's see if they're able to hold them off here.
We see Mooma in a precarious position here, and he does get eliminated almost immediately there by Mangachu, who is boosted up right now by that nano boost. We do see him very close to that ult charge as well. He's going to be able to utilize that to probably push this the rest of the way.
The whole hog really doing nothing. Tank comes through there from Mangachu, who got that rather quickly. Gonna look to finish off. Gets Mitcher looking for the Reinhardt. Doesn't even matter. What a push from Renegades. Coming up with the map completion here on Route 66. 110 remaining on that clock here.
Seems like finally Galeforce has been thwarted a little bit here, as Renegades were definitely looking fantastic after that, and kind of, I would say, a little bit of a ripple in their attacking phase once they are trying to push that second point. And we saw definitely a lot of great stuff coming out from Calvin and Boink especially, but nonetheless, we are going to be seeing Boink right now on a May, but I don't think that will stay. But
no, I gotta question. Ask you, I really have to ask you about this matchup, because we kind of discussed it earlier today before this the tournament went live. Concerning, you know, CLG, a team a lot of people have a question mark over, but Galeforce coming out with a 2-1 victory over them in the quarterfinals to get here, I think that's a big question mark for me going into this. Galeforce, you know, they did really well yesterday. They've got some new components with them, and they seem like a strong entity, but, you know, losing a map to CLG there, dropping one to Dignitas as well. What are your thoughts on their results from yesterday moving into today to take on Renegade?
I mean, I think the fact that they made it to this point is a testament that they are, I think they are growing, because Galeforce hasn't really had the results, much like CLG, in the same duration of time. We just haven't seen the results from them. The fact that they made it this far is, I think, a testament to not only what Calvin brings to the roster when he's playing with them and able to really kind of perform, but also what the other three guys bring to the table, Bonnie, Mitra, and Boink especially. I mean, like, really doing quite well with this, and it seems like things are kind of clicking for them, but this is their first match where they're actually going to be able to make a statement. And that's, I mean, I think a lot of the reason why people are thinking Galeforce has a shot here is because of the momentum that they're working off of, because they're really performing quite well. But the question becomes, is Calvin going to be able to come up with enough alongside Boink to be able to deal with Renegades, who, while they haven't had too many great results in recent memory, they still are a fantastic roster here on their NA region.
And they are looking to break the 8-series loss streak from the Winter Premiere, where they started out so strong in their initial group stage, but then just dropped 7 out of 8 of them, 2-1 losses, like I had mentioned here. But there's a nice pick from Mangachu in the skies on that Pharah. He's really going to have to deal with them. And early on, Renegades finding the picks here, getting some early ult charge. So definitely a good start to Route 66 from them.
And it definitely seems like Saibe has actually been able to flesh out this roster quite well for them so far. And we have to remember, this guy is on trial right now, and still it seems like Renegades is finally getting back to the old Renegades that we're used to seeing, that were able to do quite well against some of the top NA teams at the time. Now it seems like they're finally back in action, going up against a very emboldened Galeforce Esports that have come off of some nice wins from yesterday.
Finally, a little bit of aggression coming out here from Ultima Wep, who almost got hooked in there. Thankfully, the adjustment to the hook gonna save him for the time being here, get some decent heals, and they're looking to get aggressive once again with this. No ultimates to work with other than that nano boost from Bonnie. Both of them actually gonna be using it on each side. Juvenile, if I'm not mistaken, was the one nano boosted there from Sherlockies. They pick up two kills in the end, and they turn this back in their favor. Gonna be able to get these remaining members of Galeforce and hold them off once again. 220 on the clock, looking so good here.
So far, really, really good defense out from Renegades, and again, I mean, it just seems like they are clicking on all cylinders at the moment, and really cohesive in the way that they've been approaching these fights, and Ultima Wep, not able to find too much as of yet, and also getting Calvin onto the Zarya is a big pickup for them, because, again, insane aim on this guy.
Still not even needing to use the ultimate. Saipe actually dropped his in that last fight, but they still have four to work with. Finally, they are going to be able to pick up a kill. They have the ultimate spawn advantage here on the offensive side, but Ultima Wep, is he going to be able to get back into the map here? He's trying so hard. No, he's going to drop off. That is unfortunate. The terrain just blocking him there. Going to drop off very late, which is actually going to allow Saipe to get back to this fight in time with the rest of his team and get a regroup. And you got to be wondering, 130 on the clock here, because even if they get this checkpoint, they're not going to have much time at all to work with to get the second one and then the remainder of the map compared to 110 from Renegade.
Getting that second point, if they somehow, by some sort of luck, they actually managed to get through, and sheer willpower will have to be. I mean, that second point is going to be virtually impossible for them.
Complete whiff from Juvenile there. Tried to get Ultima Wep, but not going to be much of anything here. Sound Barrier from Jair comes through. Really, not a whole lot actually used. I think that could have been better saved for something like the Dragon Blade. Now Nano Blade out here from Ultima Wep, looking to deal with Mangachu, but Mangachu picks him up. He actually got two before that Dragon Blade got even close to him. Goes through with the emote in the end as they get the team wipe, expend all of their ultimates, but still 35 seconds now on the clock.
Really, really good position to be in if you're Renegades. And we're talking before about how Galeforce pretty much got here off of control points, and the fact that we're not going to be seeing control points in this matchup is definitely not a good sight for them, especially after this performance here on Route 66, where, I mean, honestly, Renegades has kind of shut them down.
Oh no! They needed Boink with the barrage. They needed to use that Graviton Surge combo. He's going to bring it down anyways, but there's no one there to follow up. No barrage because he got picked out from the side by Jesus. What a play coming through from him. How little it may seem, he actually opened up a world of opportunity for them to make the hold here. All they need to do is bring down the Shatter, picks up the kill with it now, looking to finish off the Genji. Barrage comes through, only picks up one kill. Muma going to get carried far away there as he actually was mid-Primal Rage, if I'm not mistaken. And that isn't able to really get a whole lot done with it, but all they need to do is finish off the Winston. They've got the Ana here. I think they have Tracer in the mix as well, but immediately, that's just Bonnie. Yeah, they take them both down here, because that's going to be it. A 0.1 hold coming out there from Renegades, who are going to end up taking Route 66. Excellent hold coming out from them.
Really great play from Renegades to start things off, and definitely setting a precedent for what we're probably going to see for the rest of this this matchup. I mean, really just shutting down all those members, and namely Calvin of Galeforce Esports, and that's a big thing for them to be able to shut down a guy like Calvin. You can see his play in the play of the match here for sure. I mean, even though they didn't actually pull out a win, Calvin's still able to perform at such a high level because just sheerly off of aim and positioning, you'll see him getting into some insane positions as well throughout the match, and somehow still Renegade's able to shut him out.
Terrific victory coming out there on Route 66 from Renegades. Guys, we're going to head to a short break, and when we're back, we'll be heading to Hollywood for a map number two, so stay with us.
Looking for new groups? Old guilds too unruly? Sick of complicated, costly VoIP calls? then you need new and improved Razer comms. You already know Razer comms is the premier way to talk with your friends both in and out of the game, but did you know about Razer comms
communities?
Communities is a great way to get your group or guild organized. Getting everyone on the same page is easy with community-wide announcements, and with the new anti-spam features, you can shut down the dorks who just want to come in and ruin the place. Using features like mute, kick, and ban, admins can keep the peace so your group feels more like a community and less like anarchy. And it won't cost you a dime. We're talking about the free premium voice solution for your guild or group. Comms uses crystal clear voice chat both in one-on-one calls and in larger group calls. And with advanced voice activation, you can avoid things like embarrassing social faux pas. The day is saved. If your friends list is looking a little sparse, you can use communities to meet new friends. Whether it's a community based on a favorite game or a favorite thing, there's a group for you. So go to razorzone.com/comms now to download comms and check out communities with your friends today.
Razer Arena is the best competitive online gaming experience you can get in on today, allowing you to set up your own tournaments and offering fully automated stat tracking. Arena is truly the best way to take your passion for gaming up a notch. Supporting games like League of Legends, Counter-Strike, World of Tanks, and more, it's easy to form your own competitive team or join one quickly using community chat. After you've got your squad together, select from any number of different tournaments going on live now. Once game day comes, Quick Check allows you to chat in a lobby with all competitors. Razer Arena gets you into your game right away so you don't miss out on the action. Game results are automatically reported back to Arena when the match is complete. And it doesn't stop there. Creating a tournament is as easy as playing in one using the tournament creation tools within Razer Arena. With custom game types like double elimination, round robin, and more, make your tournament your way. Have bracket seating for cups, and even win prizes so you can get everyone playing in one place. With no cost to participate and prizes growing every day, Razer Arena is your premier destination for tournament gaming.
Welcome back to the studio, ladies and gentlemen. As you saw at the Renegades, in a really dominating fashion, winning the first map, Route 66, taking the lead 1-0. I mean, Gale Force, they were quite dismantled. Yeah, they were quite dismantled on that first map.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know what to make of their defense on their. Yeah, what to make of their defense, and then on the offense, they honestly didn't show anything. And as we talked about backstage, I mean, wow, that performance out of Ultima Web. I honestly expected more out of him, even from Calvin, and we didn't see anything from those two players. On the other hand, Renegades, I mean, they showed up on that attack, pulling out Bastion, getting what team wipe with it.
That's definitely not something new, but it's always fun to watch.
Yeah, I mean, it was quite unexpected, so this doesn't look good for Gale Force.
Yeah, Renegades putting up a show, and they definitely showed us here what they have and how strong they are on this map. That was their pick.
Yep.
So quite unlucky for Gale Force. I mean, even though we praised them that they've beaten huge esport names along the way, but they're not showing up here in the first map.
No, that can all change. Hurix, one of our casters, is once again here with us, at least in spirit. Hurix, what is your insight from that first map? You mentioned that Genji player from Renegades needs to step up, but honestly, on the other side, Ultima Web didn't really perform.
Yeah, I think, I mean, a major reason why he has to step up is because he's a trial. I mean, he's really here to perform and show himself off, not only to the world, but also to the team itself, because he wants to make a name for himself. He wants to be a part of this roster. And I think a big reason why they were able to win out was, I mean, dating all the way back to when these guys were on Kingdom Esports with that sponsorship, they, you know, were pretty good, but it wasn't until they were actually able to get into a house and actually able to boot camp together where they really locked down their strategies and they became very cohesive, very synergistic. And it seems like where we were seeing a lot of struggles with them finding a sixth member after taking Man of Snow off the roster, then experimenting with guys like Kib, it seems like Sipe is now a really, really good, solid way for them to flesh out the roster. And because of that, they're able to really perform well. And I think they're going to continue performing well on these maps that aren't control-based, where guys like Calvin can come alive.
Galeforce, on the other hand, I mean, they beaten CLG going into this final day of the tournament, beat Dignitas, but here on the first map against Renegades, really didn't show up.
Yeah, no, I mean, definitely not at all. They really got shut down. They did a great job of shutting Boink and Calvin down, who are the guys I would definitely look toward. Ultima Web definitely does his job, but I don't think he's as flashy and, I mean, as in-your-face as those two guys, Boink and Calvin. Certainly back when he was on Method, Ultima Web definitely was in that discussion for sure, but I think he's just really kind of settled, I think, a little bit at this point, which I know will hurt a lot of people for me to say, but that's just how I feel about him at the moment. And the fact that Renegades has this particular map pool, I think, will really benefit them going forward.
Thank you, Hurix. I believe you guys said 2-1 Galeforce,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I mean, there's still a chance. No. There's still a chance, so yeah. You're switching, you know?
Yeah, I mean,
jumping onto that Renegades hype train?
Yeah, there's one point to this map that's control, but I think,
I think it's time to go into the second map. This time, it's actually King's Row. So, Hurix and Storm, take it away.
Thanks, guys. Looking forward to seeing what these guys are able to do on the defensive side here, as Renegades will be on defense first up. And going with what looks to be a dive comp on the defense, what are your initial thoughts right away here? We actually see Calvin also on the Hanzo here, finds an early
World
pick.
Star!
Doesn't matter what your thoughts are right now, Hurix, because it's all Calvin right away, finding that quick pick onto the Tracer.
That was so quick. He got the sight off from that Hanzo Sonic Arrow and was able to really just put in some damage there. Nonetheless, though, Mangachu able to really put in some work on the Pharah. And again, this is what we were talking about before with him on the Pharah. Just absolutely insane with that. One of the better Pharahs in the NA region at the moment and has been for quite a while. And really kind of saved them there, as we did see, I believe it was Calvin? Or no, sorry, it was Jesus actually that got picked off early there.
Calvin actually makes a change back over to Soldier 76, so a big turnaround right away, despite a questionable start from Renegades here, and Sipe actually getting rather aggressive. Is going to be put to sleep as Juvenile taken down by Mooma's charge. Mangachu turns around for another, grabs one here. It's Jesus in the back line wreaking havoc right now, and it's all Mangachu from the skies. He got nano boosted up as well. He's looking to finish off Calvin, turn in the corner. Calvin going to try to get away from him. Not going to be the case. He says goodbye, good night. And he already has his barrage at the ready here. It's 235. What a turnaround. Again, all on the back of Mangachu.
Yeah, I don't know if Mangachu has an editor and if he's watching right now, but he should be, because this is some highlight reel footage for him for sure. Mangachu definitely really just coming alive for Renegades at the moment and definitely setting a precedent for himself and the team now as they're holding rest of Galeforce out, and Calvin almost getting eliminated there almost immediately. Sipe gonna finish the job to open things up.
Mangachu actually got put to sleep mid-barrage as Calvin was able to sprint underneath the building and get to safety, so no kills actually came through from that one. Jesus again taken down. Sipe pops the Primal Rage here, trying to get something done, trying to get in range of Bonnie, who is all pushed all the way back to the base. But in the meantime, it's Boink and Ultima Web coming up with the kills. I think they should have this one in the bag if they can get rid of Sipe. He's going to finally be taken down. The whole hog comes through from Boink, and they should be able to take point A off of this.
Ultima Web now charged up with the barrage here. Going to have an opportunity to do pretty much exactly what Mangachu has been doing all game so far. We're going to be seeing him getting into position here, just kind of creeping around at the moment. Calvin once again also getting into position here, and look at the ult charges for both teams, but especially on the side of Renegades, because the big factor here, I mean, is that it's pretty much equivalent. I mean, the only thing that they really don't have is Mangachu that has his, but Mangachu has done so much work being able to shut down Ultima Web, and we're seeing Ultima Web trying to start things off here, and Sherlock actually gonna be taken down.
Megachu takes him down. Direct rocket hit in the skies there. Sound barrier came through as well from JR, but it's only him and Megachu remaining, and he's just forced a concussive blast his way away from this one. They might actually be able to find this late kill onto JR. He's trying to skip around here, but is it enough? He is able to get out of that one, so excellent maneuvering coming through from the Lucio, as they will force a regroup here on the defensive side. 3 minutes remaining, so plenty of time to work with here still from Galeforge.
Ultimate weapon, Megachu. I'm definitely looking forward to seeing them doing some more air battles. So far, Megachu has been able to prove very strong so far, but see if that continues.
Calvin actually put to sleep there mid nano visor, or mid pack visor. I'm not sure if he actually had the nano visor on him at the time there, but nonetheless wasn't even taken down because of Bonnie, who actually put the Reinhardt to sleep mid charge. But they're going to be forced to back off this one for the time being. Neither team really have any ultimates to work with, but they're still looking to make a move here with 2:30 on the clock, trying to tear down Juvenile's shield, see what they can get done. Jesus, of course, made the change over to the McCree now, and they're going to get aggressive about this one. I think they've split him up enough. They might be able to take down Juvenile. He's dangerously low. Saipe was taken down in the end by Muma as Nano Boost comes through there from Ultimate Web. He's at almost ready to go with his barrage. I don't even think he needs it here because they will be able to get this next checkpoint.
And Ultimate Web showing his inner Megachu right now, as he's been able to turn the tides a little bit and really put some damage down into the back line, really put some pressure onto the Reinhardt as well, is that they are going to be pushing this payload forward. And despite the performance on Renegade's side, we are seeing Galeforce just chugging away. 3:13 on the clock now, pushing forward to this last point. Well, I mean, ultimately not a bad time to be working with.
It really isn't. The initial point A hold coming out there from Renegades was actually really solid, but a good turnaround from Galeforce. They've kept the momentum in their favor, and of course they moved Jesus over to try to deal with Ultima Web, but it actually was oh man, there's a barrage from Megachu, picks up too in the end, but it was actually Ultima Web who came through with the kill on the Jesus in the end. So the McCree pick really not getting work done in the end. And they're going to try to make a hold here. Still going to go for it. Can they get on the payload? They do get onto it in time. Is Calvin going to be taken down here by Jesus? And Jesus comes through with 2 kills. And they will hold this off for the time being.
So Megachu actually, in a way, saving the day by finding those early picks. Set them up to be in a really good position to actually re-engage and win that fight out. And not only that, but also take some staggered picks in the process. Namely onto an Ultimate Web, who has been charging back into this game. Really performing quite well, on par, I would say, with Megachu in the last couple of minutes, at least.
They still do have some time to work with and some ultimates here. Jesus is just going to have to find that kill on the ultimate web rather quickly to make sure that barrage doesn't get too much work done. Bonnie, oh, there's the nano boost onto Jesus. He's going to try to get some late kills in this fight, but the rest of his team was able to clean it up for the time being. Going to get a little aggressive off this. We'll have to see if they find that last pick, but they do buy themselves a little bit more time. Looking pretty good here, X.
Yeah, not a very valuable ult there coming out from the Ana, but Sherlocky definitely saved himself as he did get the sleep dart into Reinhardt, again slowing the approach of Galeforce, so kind of saved it a little bit there, but...
Ooh, barrage from up top there. Does get Mangachu before Jesus comes through with that pick. Calvin now going to get nano boosted up. Sound barrier from Jair saves them for the time being as they come back around. There's the kill from the Helix coming through from Calvin. Picks up a crucial one onto Jesus as Sherlocky will be taken down as well. Graviton surge now from Sepe. Is there the follow-up damage? He's at 100 charge, but is it enough? Gets 2 kills to turn around off the Graviton surge. Comes up big there for Sepe, and they will be able to hold him off once again here. It's 1 minute now remaining.
They're pushing them back, and ooh, almost lands a nice hook onto Boink there as Megachu's trying to lock that one down, and Pharahs have exited the building here as, again, Megachu and Ultimate Web have made those swaps. They're going to, I guess, more of a traditional comp, but I mean, I don't know, as Jesus and Ultimate Web aren't on soldiers, but...
Nano Boost coming out there onto Juvenile, or excuse me, that came onto Muma. Is he able to get anything off it? Was just kind of knocked bound backwards, so didn't really get a whole lot off of it, as Jair kept the finishing touch onto Ultimate Web, and it looks like the rest of Muma just going to go ahead and charge out of this one, because Juvenile was one that got Nano Boosted. He's getting aggressive off of this, man. He's going to get the late kills onto Bonnie and Muma, and they still have that Earth Shatter to work with, which is big here, because 10 seconds, he can use that, and they might not be able to even get back to the payload in time.
6 seconds, time is definitely waning here, and a nice hook there onto Ultima Web. I don't think they're going to be able to contest because of that.
not going to be the case, as a huge shatter from Juvenile. Going to stop four of them short. Like you said, a big pick coming out there onto the Tracer. Going to be able to shut down any attempt. But nonetheless, they pretty much almost got the distance. But, you know, that could be the world of difference in the end as to whether or not Renegades is able to come up with that third checkpoint and potentially take the map in the series here.
Questioning what's going to be coming out from Renegades here on their attack, and certainly a lot of questions on my mind and what's going on at the Gale Force camp at the moment, because I mean, all of yesterday they performed quite well. I mean, they were able to get what I imagine to be their dream scenarios in terms of map picks and bans.
Oh, for sure.
I mean, we're talking control points all the way through. I mean, King of the Hill was a majority of what we saw on stream yesterday, and I think we saw all but one of Gale Force's matches on the over on the Play CD TV Twitch page. So, I mean, this is the first time that we're seeing them not only up against a really, really tough opponent in Renegades, who have, again, found a really, really solid six for them, it seems, but also on maps that I don't think that they ultimately wanted by any means.
Well, they also had, Gale Force definitely had one of the toughest schedules yesterday as well, up against VV's Adventures, Tempo Storm, Dignitas, and CLG. And then you look at Renegades,
granted,
who had
two of those opponents, though, are playing with EU Ping. Though.
True,
so,
true,
I mean,
but they're still
factor.
Strong. And just looking at Renegades, they had one of the easier schedules with Azo Lions and then East Wind and then Rise Nation. Of course, that's not easy, but compared to what from Gale Force had to go up against, you know, Renegades 2-0'd all their matches, looked, I mean, fairly strong across the board on it. So going into a matchup against Gale Force and practically looking like they're going to be doing the same here if they're able to come up with this third checkpoint here, we'll have to see if that's going to be the case, as they are going to be going with that dive composition once again here.
He's just sliding over on the Tracer. Calvin getting close to shutting him down after some initial damage landed onto Jesus here, and it looks like we are going to be seeing Jesus try to put some pressure onto this backline. Very Sinatra-like here in their approach.
Juvenile found that early kill there, and the fact that they got rid of that Mercy is definitely going to help them get rid of Mangachu, as Boink comes through with that kill onto Mangachu in the end. Still, it's Juvenile running around rather freely here, looking to finish off Boink, but not going to be the case for the time being. He will get that late kill onto Jesus, and they should be able to hold off this push at least for the time being here.
I still really, really like approaches that involve a dive comp with a Tracer on King's Row, because of the fact that you can slide back through that lobby, that hotel lobby, and get into the back line and just really kind of force them to turn their backs a little bit. I think that's actually the concept why Selfless has been so successful with Sinatra, is that they utilize that strategy on almost every map, and on this map in particular, I think it's incredibly strong.
What a hook coming through there from Boink, as Sherlock, he was trying to glide over to his teammate here. And Juvenile going to be taken down as well. And Boink has really come up clutch here on this initial point A defense, coming up with some big time hooks. And also the follow up, of course, with it there. So definitely a good start on the defensive side, buying every minute possible here.
They're hoping to basically hold on to their finals berth here. I mean, they really want to be able to hold this one out, because as soon as it gets to street phase, that becomes a very hard position to be getting yourself into, especially as Mangachu gets a little bit more area to kind of play with. An ultimate web shutting Mangachu down.
I'd be ready to go with the Dragon Blade, but just doesn't want to break it out just yet here. I think it's best saved. Is Sherlocky actually going to be the one to come through with the kill on the ultimate web in the end? They have that spawn advantage, but only 2 minutes remaining here. Every second will eventually count, because, you know, it's going to be a very, very quick streets phase, especially if they're holding them to the last second here. So definitely a good start, trying to move this to a game number three, of course, which, if I'm not mistaken, actually can't recall which map that would be on here. But nonetheless, they do want to push you to a game three. There's a sound barrier coming out there from Mitcher. We'll have to see if Ultimate Web breaks out the Dragon Blade here. They've got the Nano Boost to work with as well. There's a sound barrier coming through there from Jer, trying to hold off. Calvin actually going to be taken down by Jesus here. Nano Blade comes out from Ultimate Web, looking to finish up the Mercy. Can't quite get him, no. Misses all of it. Saipe comes through. There's two return kills from Ultimate Web. Eventually gets Mangachu and Sherlocky. A rough start with the Dragon Blade, but turns around and comes up clutch.
Like, it's just Ultimate Web here to try to jump on this and defend, and he's up against a Winston on top of just the rest of Renegades, who is going to be able to lay him down, and Sherlocky finally managing here to get his ultimate charged up. So Resurrect is going to be available through this Streets phase, which is going to be big for them because that's going to allow guys like Mangachu to go forward, be aggressive, try to find those kills. And Mangachu is incredibly strong in this Streets phase on the Pharah, in my opinion. I think he's going to really kind of come alive here. We're going to see him do a lot of big things. Saipe is still really putting in some damage himself. And I mean, this triple DPS threat needs to come alive right now if they want to be able to push this to the second objective point.
It really does. Ultima Weapon, of course, made the change over to the Pharah now, so no Genji to really work with. And that was a big nuisance for Sherlocky, and the fact that Sherlocky... Oh, nice pick! The direct rocket hit from Mangachu. Gonna shut that down immediately, and they're just gonna get so aggressive off this. There's the hook on the Mangachu. Knockout. Oh, man, the Earthshatter coming through as well. Not quite gonna have any follow-up, though, as they do pick up a couple of kills, but it looks like, for the most part, Calvin's gonna be taken down. He does manage to get the health back and get out of this one alive. Mooma still in the mix here, trying to get to safety, trying to shield himself off from the rockets from the Pharah here, but they are still moving the payload in the end.
Calvin, as elusive as ever, manages to wiggle his way away from Mangachu, and Mangachu has really not been answered as much. I mean, very aggressive playstyle, incredibly proficient in landing his rockets and being incredibly accurate. I mean, a virtual marksman with these rocket directs and being able to shut down Ultima Web, as well as pinning out Calvin, which is really his major threat in this matchup.
There's the tag visor coming out from Calvin right into the barrage, takes him down. He got nano boosted, of course, as well, which helped him out in the end, getting rid of that Pharah. We also saw the Earthshatter from Juvenile, but nothing really happened off of it, to say the least here. So it looks like Gale Force will be able to continue to get aggressive off this one. 1:35 on the clock here. Not a whole lot of time to work with if you are Renegades.
Now we're seeing Gale Force actually in a pretty solid position. I mean, when we saw them pushing through, Gale Force looked like they were kind of struggling, but defensively now it seems like they've really kind of been able to turn things around. A really nice biotic grenade there coming out from Sherlocky, and they need to make sure that they're continuing the support here. And I like this switch actually from them getting off the Mercy. Seems like this setup is definitely a lot better. And they do manage to get that pick off on Boink, and they're going to be able to now engage with the 6v5 Mangachu in the skies.
There's the Dragon Blade from Saipe. Gets laid on the ground by Mooma. The charge straight into him. What a play. Honestly, that was point saving, potentially game saving. It was a 6-on-5, but a big shatter. Even if it only did hit him, it was, you know, two ultimates in play, the Dragon Blade and the Nano Boost. So it ends up paying big for Gale Force here. Now 35 seconds remain here. It's pretty much one final hold. If they hold this one off, we are going to be heading to a game number three once again here in the semifinals.
Link has been playing out of his mind so far, and despite him actually getting picked off early in that last engagement, they were able to still hold on without him. And we've seen time and time again his hooks have saved the day, but weren't required this time. Great stuff from Gale Force to actually turn that one back around. And it looks like we're seeing some entry picks happening. Actually, Boink going to be eliminated once again here. Calvin needs to turn this thing back around with this Nano Visor.
Barrage doing really nothing from Ultima Web. Mooma going to get hooked in by Mangachu, finding a nice pick for themselves here. They've got the numbers. They just need to take care of Calvin and Bonnie here, as Calvin still, like you said, so elusive. They are going to be able to come up with the checkpoint, but with a very limited amount of time to get to the end. Of course, they don't need to finish out the map with the remaining 130, but that's pretty much on it. Yeah, it's pretty much on it, to say the least. So they are going to be going with the Bastion strategy for the second consecutive map, Urix. And it worked for them on Route 66 rather well, I might add.
I definitely like that they're willing to go for this kind of Protect the President style. Although they don't have a Zarya or anything to really protect them from just an aggressive flashover or anything like that. We are going to be seeing Ultima Web just jump on top of him, and Calvin going to finish the job.
There's the Nano Blade from Saipe trying to get something down again. No, not quite hit by the Earthshatter. He was on the very edge of it. It looked like it might have connected, but Saipe, as like you said, the trial member coming up huge here with a Dragon Blade, and they could very well finish this one. Mangachu getting ran back by Jair. Is it enough to get the job done? They are able to get onto the payload. They do have Boink, of course, on the May, trying to hold off as long as they possibly can, but Mangachu is now in stationary mode. He's trying to get through them, trying to push down that Reinhardt shield. We'll have to see if they can hold on. Sound Barrier coming through there on the offensive side from Jair. Bastion not in the greatest position to be able to find some damage, though. Calvin gonna be taken down, so is Boink on the May. That's bad. Mitcher getting taken down by Mangachu. Nano Boost coming through on the Muma. He's gonna get put to sleep, but woken back up by the Bastion. That's gonna be it. Renegades turn it around. They take the map. They take the 2-0 series. They will be in the finals to take on Selfless.
Renegades pulling out some nuttiness with the Bastion twice in a row, and Mangachu not only doing well with the surprise Bastion pick that may not have been as much of a surprise in this last one, but coming alive as well in the earlier stages of the map on the Pharah and really, really performing at levels that Mangachu is definitely known for and kind of got famous for, and was a big reason why they picked him up here on the Renegades roster. You know, and man,
you gotta hand
really
it to
Saipe,
man.
Absolutely.
You really do. This play alone gave them a window of a big opportunity as a trial play to really stand out and show him what he's made of. As like I said, Renegade's going to be taking the series 2-0 there over Gale 4.